Good evening and welcome to one more episode of Lex Peeps interview series. Today we have with us Senior Consultant, Competition Law, Lex Indies Law Offices, and an expert of Senior Consultant, Competition Law, Dr. Vijay Kumar Agarwal. I welcome you all to in this new session, where we will be discussing the nuances of competition law with Sir. Sir has also served as course in charge to various colleges like Symbiosis University and NLU Delhi. I welcome you, Sir.
Thank you.
So the first question is, you have a vast experience in the field of law. How would you describe your journey so far?
At the outset, I must be thankful to Lex Peeps for inviting me for this interactive session. Thank you very much, Madhur.
Thank you, sir.
With regard to your question, I will tell you, I am a first generation lawyer and started my independent practice at the age of 40 in October 1993. For initial few years, I was operating from home and even doing all clerical work of such as filing, etc. of my own. For commuting, I was availing the services of public transport, three-wheeler scooter, etc. Thus, in the beginning of independent practice, I have faced all such hardships which one faced by the first generation lawyer. It was my passion for competition law that I quit the gazetted post of the government to start my independent practice. I may add that when I joined bar in October 1993, I had a practical experience of various quasi-judicial, oblique-judicial authorities and tribunals of more than 20 years that boldened me to enter into the legal profession.
Very beautifully said, so.
Yes.
So the next question is, what motivated you to choose competition law?
Okay, Madhur, you see that I am a postgraduate in commerce and the topic of my PhD research was unfair trade practices in India under the MRTP Act. Thus, I have both economic and law background. Competition law is a mixture of law and economics. This was the prime motivation to choose competition law as the main practice area after some years of my independent practice.
So that's a truly great answer. So the next question is, what are some of the challenges that you faced during the initial years of your practice?
I think that the answer to this question is covered in my answer to your first questions. Yes, above.
Yes, sir. You talked about your hardships and all the things.
Correct.
Yes, sir.
Correct.
Sir, how do you feel about the present competition law regime in India?
You see that, Madhur, with respect to competition law regime in India, I am to say that substantive law is under Section 3 and under Section 4 of the Competition Act 2002. Section 3 is dealing about prohibition of anti-competitive agreements, whereas Section 4 is dealing about prohibition of abuse of dominant position. These provisions were notified with effect from 20th May 2009, means thereby almost 11 years have passed since the enforcement of the substantive provision, and during this period, so far as these substantive provisions are concerned, Competition Commission of India has not faced any major blockage in pursuing the goal of the Competition Act. One thing more, the Section 5 is dealing with the regulatory provision of combination. This was notified with effect from 1st June 2011. Means almost 9 years have passed, and similarly, Commission has not faced any major problem in implementing these provisions. However, I may add that there are several procedural issues with regard to the functioning of the Competition Commission of India and Office of the Director General under the Competition Act, which have been challenged from time to time, and many of these obstacles have been resolved by the various authoritative judgments by the Honorable Supreme Court or High Courts.
Definitely.
For example, I will give you that penalty on which amount is to be imposed by the competition for violating these substantive provisions. The earlier view of the Competition Commission was that the total turnover of the enterprise may be taken for the purpose of calculating the turnover. However, the Supreme Court in Excel Corp case has defined the definition of turnover. They have said that turnover means turnover relating to the product regarding which contravention has been made, not the total turnover of the company. One more point I will tell you that earlier there were some misapprehension that CCI cannot issue prima facie order without giving notice to the opposite party. The Supreme Court in sale authority matter have said the prima facie order under subsection 1 of section 26 is an administrative order, and there is no need to give any notice to the opposite party. Therefore, now the things are clear, and there are much more issues which will be decided during the, these are still there. Let us hope that all these controversies may be resolved.
Definitely so. It was a great answer, sir. The next question is, how essential are internships for anyone who intend to specialize in competition law, and what are some of the internships they could undertake?
You see that, Madhur, this question is indeed a best question so far, because it relates to the students who are doing the law, and I must congratulate you for the same. I will tell you, as per my understanding, competition law is being taught to the students of fourth year or fifth year during their law graduation, not prior to that. So my suggestion is that the students, and that too, competition law is an optional subject. It's not a compulsory subject. So those students who are seeking or opting for competition law and are serious in pursuing in competition law in their professional career, in my view, they must take internship in some law firm which have some work of competition law to get an exposure. I have seen that independent lawyers or individual lawyer have little work relating to competition law, because these states under competition law for any corporates are very, very high. Therefore, corporates are not giving work to individual lawyer. And the state is 10% penalty, up to 10% penalty of the turnover. So the corporates normally are sending their work to law firms. So the student who is interested in pursuing the competition law as a career, he may take the internship in some law firm well behind during his fourth year or fifth year, because prior to that, heavy internship for competition law is of no consequence. At least he must be aware of what is the competition law. And secondly, you have asked that from what are some of the internship they could undertake. To my understanding, Competition Commission of India is also giving internship to the law students, and for this purpose, the students may look at the website of the CCI when they are inviting the applications, etc., for internship. Is that clear, Madhur?
Yes, sir. That's totally a great answer. I think it will definitely guide the law students. Sir, what are the skills that is required for a competition lawyer? How can they work on acquiring those specific skills? Like, you have a vast experience. Can you highlight those skills?
You see that, Madhur, I have told you, competition law is a mixture of economics and law. So those students who have a background of economics during their graduation, they are better equipped to understand the competition law. Otherwise, those who are not with the economic background, they can acquire the knowledge of the competition law by studying the book themselves and acquire it. So the basic knowledge or skill required for practitioner competition law is the knowledge of the economics, which a student must acquire it. And to my knowledge, the IICA, it comes under Ministry of Corporate Affairs. They are organizing diploma / certificate courses for competition law for the duration of 1 year or 6 months. Those who are really serious, they can see the website of IICA in this regard to get more information.
Great, sir. Definitely, sir. Sir, how would you describe the Indian competition law as compared to that of UK or USA?
I will tell you that Indian competition law is broadly based on European Union competition law. It contains in the Treaty of Function of European Union. It is called TFEU. Article 101 of TFU of European law is similar to Section 3 of Competition Act. Similarly, Article 102 is equivalent or similar to Section 4 of the Competition Act. UK Competition Act is of 1998. Normally, UK has largely aligned competition law to that of EU, means thereby EU and UK law are similar. As our Indian law is similar to EU, therefore EU, UK and Indian law are almost on the same pattern. However, US law is based on Sherman Act and it is different from EU or Indian. It is based on a criminality of the act and is being tried by the district courts there. There is also a Federal Trade Commission, Federal Trade Commission Act. They are filing the cases of anti-competitive agreements or cartel or other things or monopolization. There they are using the words monopolies. Here we are using the word abuse of dominance. So you may see that their FTC and DOJ, Department of Justice, they are looking after the antitrust law. The major act is Sherman Act. And thereafter, Clayton Act is also there of 1940, which is dealing with the merger and acquisition, etc. So, in nutshell, word over, there are three types of anti-competitive practices. One is that of prohibition of anti-competitive agreements, which includes the horizontal and vertical agreements. Second one is called the abuse of dominance. In America, they may call it a monopoly. Here, we are calling it abuse of dominance. And thirdly, the matter relating to combinations, that is merger, acquisition, and amalgamation. So, this is the in a broad sense, about the competition law world over.
That's great, sir. You described it so beautifully, sir. Sir, on a concluding note, what will be your appeal to the budding lawyers who wish to build their career in competition law?
My good wishes to the lawyers who are opting for competition law. I will request them to keep update themselves about the latest position of competition law. And how can they do that? They must keep an eagle eye on the latest judgments of the from the Supreme Court, from the High Courts, from the Competition Commission, from the National Company Law Appellate Tribunal, because the appeals of CCI will lie to National Company Law Appellate. So, and similarly, they must keep eye on the judgments by EU, because our law is broadly based on EU. So my request to the lawyers that they must keep abreast of the latest law, so that whenever they go for interview for any, so they can tell that this is the latest position which will impress their employer. And during their study, they must keep noting the judgments. They must prepare their notes, because by preparing notes, they are remembering it very quickly. So I always suggest to the students that they must prepare their self notes for this purpose.
That's great, sir. I think all of the viewers will find this helpful in long run. And whatever inputs that you have gave, sir, thank you for being with us in this session.
Thank you. Thank you, Madhur, for inviting. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, sir. Thank you for being with us.
Thank you.